We had the honor and privilege of performing about 6 weeks ago at Carnegie Hall in the Newport Jazz Festival. And the part of the festival of which we were a part was a tribute to the late Eddie Jefferson and a celebration of vocalese. And we appeared on the same bill along with John Hendricks and his family and Ben Sidran and Richie Cole and James Moody and Dizzy Gillespie. And we had a wild time, I'll tell you. But this was, as we said, a tribute to Eddie Jefferson, who was a very big influence on the Manhattan Transfer. And he was sort of the father of this whole thing called vocalese. And what we would like to do right now is Eddie's first lyrical composition that he composed when he was 20 years old. And he did it as he was inspired by the very great improvisation that Coleman Hawkins performed on the song Body and Soul. This is it.
Don't you know he was the king of saxophones? Yes, indeed he was. Talking about the guy that made it sound so good. Some people knew him by the beam, but Hawkins was his name. He sure could swing and play pretty too. Sounds good to me, should sound good to you. I love to hear him playing body and soul, very pleasing to the ear. When I first heard it on the record, I just stopped right there. Sounded like a band of angels in the sky, and I have never ever heard a sweeter tone. In fact, I paid no attention to the saxophone.
Oh no.
When we heard we were doing soundstage, we were in a real big hurry to get to Chicago because we knew that soundstage had tapes of a lot of past shows that they had done with wonderful jazz greats, and of course for us jazz singers, people like Eddie Jefferson, John Hendricks, Annie Ross, and Leon Thomas. And these were shows that we had missed when we were on the road, so we really couldn't wait to sit down and take a look at them.
Remember she told me when we met her in London, she told us about Four Brothers and the Shake.
Oh yeah, that was one of the first jazz pieces that I got hit to when I was a kid. My bass was Little Darling. Oh man, I used to love to sing that. Symphony City used to always play that on the radio. Oh man.
You know, that's what Hendricks means in the opening line of Birdland, 5,000 light years from Birdland. You know, and then that it was only 20 years ago that people were putting this stuff down, and it's like, where did it go, you know? Right. Remember what Dizzy showed you when he was going like this?
Hope the beat and any both would still approve. There we go. We didn't mean to reminisce. You can surely bet that we won't forget, 'cause we hear them yet. Good.